Hey there, y'all. Model Man here. Y'all wonder why I call myself the Model Man? Well, you know, as many of you know on Facebook, I'm a person that likes to set an example, like to be a good mentor for a lot of people. So, you know, I have somebody here today that does the exact same thing that I do, and that really believes that anything she can do it and do it for multiple reasons to make sure that somebody out there is going to get her message. Now, today, most people ask a lot of questions to everybody, and you want to know everything there is to know about a person. Well, you know what, y'all? I got the opportunity for you today. I'm going to be up close and personal with the author, TyLeishia Douglas. So y'all stick around, because we got a lot of things that somebody out there want to know. And I know one of y'all going to be like, oh, okay, that's what's up, okay? So yeah, y'all stick around, because we got a lot of good information for y'all. Welcome back, y'all. I have here with me TyLeishia Douglas, aka
JDNM.
All right, so I got the questions right here in my hand. I know everybody burning to know some things. We're gonna get started with that right now. We're gonna get started. So, TyLeishia, some questions that people want to know. Let's start with the big ones from the top. Are you single?
Yes, I am.
Okay, well, that's all right. Why is that?
Well, I'm still working, perhaps there might be a special name.
Who knows? Okay, well, I'm quite sure all you people on Facebook, all you Facebook stalkers, what is it that you look for in a man?
Well, a lot of times I'm asked that question, and I'm like, hey, if you have to ask me, a lot of times I'm like, it might not be in you. And the reason why is because I think if you are interested in a person, I think you should study that individual. So, to me, I think it wouldn't be in you if you gotta ask.
Yep.
I don't mean that in a mean way. I don't mean that, guys, in a mean way. But what I do mean is, if you are interested, nobody has a crystal ball, and we certainly understand that. But if you're interested in somebody, at least study them. So.
I hear you on that one. I know that. All right. Well, how do you deal with being single and working, staying busy?
I have my work to keep me going. There's always lots to do. Studying my craft, marketing, continuously thinking about things to write about. It's always something. To get into something to do, places to go.
So do you have the urge to learn?
I do. I actually go out a lot to functions that I'm invited to. I meet a lot of people, great people, in fact. A lot of authors, some jazz artists, a little bit of, just a little bit of something in everybody that I like. But again, my time is actually sewed up in writing and promoting. So, like I said before, that takes care of the urge to focus.
All right. That's good. All right. Well, I guess some of you people want to know as well. I'm quite sure a lot of people want to know that. Do you ever, date anybody from Facebook? With anybody? Would there be any time that, that you would actually feel the need or feel the, not the need, but the, the urge to date anybody?
No.
Okay, well, So, I guess that's enough. Now, something about that, I know how I would feel about it. Some people, you never know how strange that can be. That can, I know you can be under a lot of pressure. People probably always have things that they look for in you, or look for out of you. So, what would be something, why would you feel that you couldn't take that to that level?
Well, that's just like having, your favorite celebrity on a poster, on a wall. I mean, what can you do with that? Hmm. Okay? Think about it. I just think that a lot of times people fall in love with the idea of a person's personality on Facebook. I mean, what you're getting here right now is who I really am. I love to inspire. I love to motivate. When it's about business, it's about business. But I don't see the need or the urge, if you will, to, I don't reach out on Facebook for a date. No, I mean, come on.
I certainly said that would be something very awkward to deal with. I mean, given the fact that, you know, you are an author.
Yes.
And, you know, there's a lot of things that, you know, goes on and you're going to stay busy. I know writing is definitely something that's a challenge. That's a challenge.
I mean, there's life outside of that, and I certainly understand that. Yeah,
so,
again, I'm focused.
That is one. Okay, so, you know, have there been any people that you've ever, you know, come across, you know, that would say, you know, is she the same way that she is or appears to be online, or, you know, would there be any difference? You know, would you say that anybody characterizes you one specific way?
I hear that a lot. A lot of people say, oh, where does she get her energy from, you know? I hear that a whole lot. Again, I love to inspire. I love inspiration. I love positivity. I think that's what gives me the drive to pretty much just stay focused in a positive realm. When the negative clouds come about, you know, a lot of times you have to encourage yourself. And when those times get rough, I'm blessed to have people in my life that I can talk to. I follow people who inspire and admire others that can pick up those dark clouds. So I try to do my best at staying energetic on, I guess, positivity. And if you could just constantly work on that and just tell yourself every day, I mean, I'm just like anybody else. When things go low, okay, and sometimes I do feel that way. But there are moments where I'm like, you know what? You don't waddle there. It's okay to feel that way, but you don't want to remain either. So,
yeah.
Do something to turn it around.
That's true. That is very true. Okay. Well, you know, it's a good feeling there.
It is.
All right. Well, you know, something that I think I have, you know, more of an interest in. And I have a question a lot of other people want to know as well. It's something that I came across as a question that, you know, I would like to know for myself. You know, is, you know, what drives you to want to help or give back?
You know what? I was not always a giver. Oh, surprise! Yeah! I was not always a giver. I actually came through some tough times. And I had to own up to those things that I needed to change, and that had to change. And who better to do that than yourself? I always believe that openness is the beginning stages to healing. And once you can do that, it's uphill from there.
That's good. All right. Well, if I asked you to go on a date with me, would you say?
No.
All right. Okay. All right. You know, well, what would you say to guys that, you know, inbox you and they want to get to know you better?
Well, I think that this is why I do the interviews like I'm doing today. Mm-hmm. You can, you know, kind of hear what I have to say and learn from that.
All right. Well, something else I think a lot of people want to know is, you know, given the fact that, you know, you are single right now, is there any hope for children? Do you want any children?
Well, you know what? I never knew how to answer that question. It was never something that I actually had, I guess, on the list of things to do. I love children, by the way. I do. They're awesome. But when it came to, I've had people say it all the time, do you ever want any kids? You know, or would you have any kids? You know, I'm going to be perfectly honest with you. We have so many in the world, you know, that I'm attached to. I feel like I do have them already.
Okay. Well, that's wonderful. I'm quite sure there's many young, youthful children that look up to you. I'm quite sure.
Definitely.
Very inspiring.
Definitely. I have nieces, I have nephews, I have godchildren, so I'm blessed.
Bless she is. All right. Well, you know, something that, you know, is hard, I guess, these days. You know, you see movies, and I'm quite sure we've all seen movies that differentiate, you know, between the men and the women out here that know what they're looking for. But what is it that you want in a man, or you look for in a man to romance you? What is it that you would be so, oh, this is so romantic about?
I don't kiss and tell. But I will tell you this much. As you learn me, I think I'll just bring the answer that I gave to you early on when you asked what I date, or, you know, what have you. Again, I think if you study an individual, you know, you'll know what that person likes. They know what you like, and I like surprises. It keeps the flame high.
Yeah.
So,
all right.
You can make your assumption from that.
Okay. All right. Okay, well, then, is there any celebrity, any specific celebrity that you would like to,
Idris Elba. Are you there, hon? Are you there? That takes care of that.
Hello there, everybody. Today I'm here. Start over. It's time for us to say goodbye. So, what are you hoping for? What do you want to see happen for you this moment?
I want to see my stories play on the big screen, like any other author, you know. I want to see you actually. I'll be the producer of my own movies. What it takes to be alive, the sacrifices made for love, hoping you would change. I want to become the producer of my own work.
Oh, well, when you make it big, what do you want to do with that kind of money?
Well, I do want to take care of my family. I want to make sure that there's some centers that are open, like Big Sister, Big Brother programs, writing centers for authors, because authors, you know, they are not respected as much as they should be. It's a lot of work that goes into self-publishing, so I think I would just have, you know, things like that, be able to donate to the Cancer Society and different places like that. So there's always places that need assistance, and if there's anything that I can do to perhaps help that out, you know, help out with that, I really would love to take some of that money and just kind of see things happen.
Well, who markets you?
I do. I love it. I own videos. Well, of course, I'm not videoing myself right now. you got your producers working on that, but. I market my own stuff, you know. I'm my own promoter. I love promoting. I just do. Like, you know, I love to see everybody else shine. So, I do my own stuff.
And I noticed that you don't ask for reviews.
Well, I think it's a blessing, first and foremost. The ebooks that I have online right now on Amazon, Kobo, Smashwords, I don't ask for reviews because to me, that is a privilege, I think. I'm blessed to have people ultimately purchase my work. And besides, I mean, you know, I'm pretty much confident in my work, and that's why they buy it. And of course, I would love a review. It's, you know, it's not that I wouldn't like a review. I think it's a plus. I think that's a double honor if someone wants to give me a review. But I just think that that's privilege. So I think it should be left up to the reader, you know.
I guess something that, you know, is hard for a lot of people to really understand is that I know there's life outside of, you know, just what you do and, you know, things like that nature. I know writing is mostly your focal point, the things that you want to get out and, you know, inspiring and things of that nature. But what are some things that you would like doing outside of writing? What is, you know, what is the real TyLeishia like to get into other than writing?
Yeah, I like bowling. Don't laugh. One day I went bowling by myself and I went like this and the ball just went the whole opposite way. Did I expose that? Yes, I did. I like to dine. I like, you know, just riding down the highway and clearing my mind and just taking in the air and just, you know, just being able to appreciate. I like to eat. I like to, you know, I like jazz. So I like to go to jazz clubs and I'm not going to spoil it all. I'm not going to have nothing left for the fellas to
know that. Well, speaking of the fellas, has any of those Facebook guys ever told you that they may have had a crush on you?
You know what? If they did, I probably didn't catch it. Again, you know, I just kind of revert them to my website or, you know, something like that. But if they did, I probably didn't catch it.
So I okay, all right. Well then, you know, I guess, what are some people that may inspire you? I mean, I know you inspire a lot of people. You know, you may have a lot of weight on your shoulders of what to say to others when, you know, they're in need and they need, you know, someone to help them get themselves back into a place where they need to be as far as being comfortable with life and, you know. But what you know, what would be some inspirations for you? Who inspires you?
Well, Rona Bennett, she is a major inspiration for me. She is known from En Vogue. She also played on the Jamie Foxx show. I actually go by her blogs, her vlogs. She's a life coach. She is just like a huge inspiration to me. I mean, she's a motivator. She's a go-getter. So she's a big part of, you know, why I actually love to motivate. She always says, keep going, you know, and she's a realist. I love her because she keeps it real. And someday I'm going to meet you, Ro. That's my girl. Love her to death. I have Deidre Diaz Green, who is my mentor. I know she says, don't call me your mentor anymore. We're mentor / mentee. But, you know, she's also a good friend of mine. So a lot of times, you know, she's there, you know, when I'm not feeling up to par. And, you know, there's Facebook friends that I have. There's this one young lady. She always puts up some funnies. And she's so sweet. And she always puts these little funnies up. So it's quite a few people in my corner that I could turn to. My godparents, I love you guys. Mm-hmm. You know, so it's just, I have people who are around me that I can ultimately talk to. And they uplift me. And I'm just blessed to be able to have that.
All right, well. You know, one of your fan base wants to know that, you know, since you've been the person you've been and, you know, you've come so far, well, you know, how do you feel about the book, Jewels Declaring Miracles? You know, it's coming out, and, you know, that's wonderful, but, you know, are you concerned at all with any opinions of that nature?
Definitely not. As I stated earlier, openness to me is the beginning stages of healing, and I feel great about this book. The book actually mirrors, I can relate to it because it mirrors a lot of some of the things that I've been through. The character DeVise in Jewels Declaring New Miracles is a young lady who basically went through a whole lot. I can relate to that young lady, so I'll just leave it up to the readers. You know, wherever you think I fit in, you know, you think I fit in, but I can definitely relate to a lot of the story, Jewels Declaring New Miracles. JDNM, actually, those acronyms come from that. So now you know. I Am Jane Doe No More in the beginning because I wanted to wait until it was time for the book to almost come out. So it's going to be coming out soon, beginning year of 2013.
All right. And the book is about your life, right?
Well, again, it mirrors a lot of some of the things that I have ultimately been through in life.
Okay. Well, what made you write? What really inspired that to be something to give a story about?
Well, a long time ago, back in August of 2001, I don't know what started it, but I sat down and I wrote my feelings out. And I think I wrote up to like 8 pages. My mom found those pages because I thought I lost them. And she was like, you gotta come get these pages. I was like, oh, I'll do away with that. And I'm glad that I didn't. When I got the pages back, I was like, whoa, wow. I decided to keep them. And there was an instructor at the college that I went to. And I let her take a look at them. The next thing you know, the college instructor says, you know what? This has a potential to be a book. I said, you think so? She says, oh, I know so. Next thing you know, she has me in school for like 2 years, which was awesome. And I just kept writing from that moment on. And things that, you know, that I didn't think was there, just all spilled out on paper.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. Okay. I had a couple more here. So, you know, where did this JDNM come from? That's what I want to know. That's what the crux of everything is. Where did JDNM come from? I want to know. What was that about?
JDNM is, again, Jules Declaring Miracles. And to me, if you're an individual who declares new things all the time, then are you not a Jewel who's declaring a new miracle? So it's not just me as JDNM. I see anybody else who's declaring forwardness, progression. That's a Jewel declaring a new miracle. Are you not JDNM?
I believe I am. Are you guys? Okay. you know, well, you know, have you always been this amazing person?
Not at all. Not at all. Amazing, I think, was very hidden. I'm not going to say that I wasn't amazing. Perhaps I did not know my own inner light. A lot of people was not able to see it. Neither was I. A lot of darkness was surrounding that. And I think that ultimately came from a lot of things that I did not understand about life, about myself. And I think what happened is, as you go on, as you grow on, the light begins to unfold. But you have to be willing to do the work. Do the work within yourself. You know, those things that you know that you have to own up to. You have to say, I'm not going to sit back and I'm not going to let those things that got the best in me just ruin me and dim my light. No. You have to say, I'm going to take what was supposed to have ruined me and I'm going to have my light ruin the darkness. So you just have to turn it around. You have to crack up those little areas and you have to work hard at it. And you have to say, you know what? I am the light. And let it shine.
Let it shine. Okay. That's right. All right. Well, thank you, TyLeishia.
Thank you.
You know, for taking the time to answer your followers, you know, your supporters. You know, we're all here because we want you to continue to inspire.
Thank you so much.
We look forward to that. I'm quite sure everybody out there, you know, I'm hoping that everything that, you know, you wanted to know, you can now rest with all that. But if you want to, you can follow TyLeishia. You know, she's on Twitter, she's on Facebook. You can follow her blogs. We'll have all that information. Just, you know, make sure you check out the links that's provided for you on the screen. And, you know, if there's anything that, you know, that you would like to know from her,
give her a house.
But is there anything that, you know, you want to say just going out? You know, just is there anything you want to say to anybody, you know, specifically, or anything you want to leave with anybody?
I want to thank all of my supporters just for being there for me. I just want to tell anybody that feels that you feel like it's too late, it's never too late. Rona, thanks so much. I'm going to spread the same word that you gave to me to others, and that is keep going. Keep growing. There's more to come.
Welcome back, y'all. We got